What is going on, guys? This is Jesse for Gamers Unite, and today I will be covering the recent changes made to Bastion. So, Bastion, we all know as kind of the troll of the Overwatch world. You know, he's got the most memes probably out of most of the heroes, and he's generally not taken seriously by the competitive scene, or really even the casual scene for that matter. This is mostly due to the fact that before these changes were made, in his previous state, he was just never a viable option for any team that maybe took themselves seriously enough, or really wanted to win, or choose the best team composition possible. He was never really a serious option, and anytime you basically saw Bastion being picked on a team, you either thought, wow, this will be an easy game, or they're gonna do a cheese method, they're gonna try and do a cheese strat, like putting Bastion on the payload with a Reinhardt or do some silly stuff like that. So, I think it's a good thing that Blizzard has finally decided to address this situation and, you know, try and make Bastion more of a serious pick, or, you know, a character that can actually be used or be viable in, you know, more scenarios, and especially in the competitive scene. Now, Bastion is an interesting character as far as development and balancing goes. If we go back to the launch of the game almost a year ago, if you played it during launch, you would notice that everyone was completely freaking out about this character, Bastion. He's the easiest character to play. All you gotta do is sit in sentry mode in a corner, maybe put a Reinhardt in front of you, and just, you know, click to win, basically. And a lot of people during launch were saying that he needed to be nerfed, and that was mostly due to the fact that people haven't been playing the game enough, and you know, they didn't fully realize how to play against him or to counter him properly. And the great thing about Overwatch is that, you know, any character can technically be overpowered depending on the team comp, or you know, there's a proper way to use a character. And with Bastion, you know, people didn't really know at the time how to counter him properly. Now we know we can use someone like a Hanzo or a Widowmaker to snipe them from afar, or, you know, probably the best counter to an unexperienced Bastion would be a good Genji. You know, there's a lot of ways that you can deal with Bastion, even Roadhog if he gets in close to Bastion. And you know, once players put enough time into the game, they started figuring out that Bastion wasn't so great of a character. Fast forward to today, before they've made this patches recently and buffed him, he was basically not used at all. So now we're kind of having the same problem where Blizzard decided to make a ton of changes to Bastion, trying to actually make him a viable character, or at least a serious pick in just even casual games and maybe even the competitive scene. And we're finding that players right off the bat testing him in the PTR said he is just too powerful now. And I'll go down, you know, I'll go into detail and break down the details of his changes here. So before I go into the actual changes themselves, this is the notes from the developer stating that the goal of these changes is to move some of Bastion's power from configuration, sentry to recon, while keeping its sentry mode a strong option, especially versus tanks and barriers. Overall, Bastion should feel stronger and more flexible with these changes. So, the main point of these changes was basically a lot of it being to make him more of a viable option to use in recon mode, as before these changes were made, you would never see a Bastion running around in recon mode other than when he's, you know, trying to move positions to set up sentry somewhere else or running away in a situation where he is outnumbered. So his biggest change, and probably the most controversial change that they did make, was his new passive ability called Ironclad. And the passive ability basically gave him a 35% damage reduction while in configuration mode, sentry, and his tank mode, which is his ultimate ability. So basically, while he's in his sentry mode, or using his ultimate, he would take 35% less damage. And this was to make him feel a bit less suicidal when going into the sentry modes. Mainly because we all know if a Bastion is not placed properly in sentry mode, he is just absolutely obliterated. So this is to make him a little bit more survivable in sentry mode. Now, this is the main thing that people complained about, and it was soon after changed. So he came out of PTR with his Ironclad ability being reduced to 20% instead of 35%. Now, also a lot of changes made to his sentry mode. First of all, being his reconfiguration time was decreased from 1.5 seconds to 1 second, basically just making it faster to go in and out of sentry mode. That way, if you have yourself in a bad position in sentry mode, that gives you a little bit more time to get the hell out of there and heal up and post yourself in a better position. His bullet spread was also increased by 50% while in sentry mode. Bullet spread is always at maximum now, and it no longer increases as the weapon is fired. The magazine size has been increased from 200 to 300, and it no longer deals critical damage. So you can see that with some buffs being made to his sentry mode, you know, they also had to make some nerfs also to make up with his new Ironclad passive ability. So no longer dealing critical damage is a little bit of a nerf that they had to make to make up for the positive changes. So you can see that this was definitely a tough call to make these changes and push out an actual, you know, fair and balanced Bastion. Now, not a lot of changes were made to specifically his recon configuration, but his bullet spread was decreased by 25%, which is obviously a great change because it was just absolutely, you know, a mess before, and the damage wasn't all that great in the first place. And other than that, the magazine size was increased from 20 to 25. So not a huge change for his recon mode, but it's actually the introduction of his self-repair ability and the buffs that were made to his self-repair ability that made recon mode a little bit more viable now. So self-repair can now be used while moving, and this is one of the biggest changes to his recon configuration, because basically before, if you needed to heal while in combat, you needed to run away. Basically, you know, if you tried to heal when you were getting fired at in sentry mode, you'd most likely die unless you had like a mercy on you or a healer with you. So now you can actually, you know, run away while taking damage and healing at the same time, because it is also no longer interrupted by taking damage. So, you know, it's makes him a lot more survivable while in recon mode, while also making it more viable to actually be running around in recon mode. You can actually, if you're good enough, you have good aim, can actually get some kills while in recon mode now. And it's basically not a joke anymore to be walking around on recon mode. It's actually viable to use, you know, you know, his walking form rather than just sitting in a turret for the entire game. But also with this ability means that when you are in sentry mode, if you're in a good position, depending on how much damage you're taking, it also means that you could potentially heal through damage, depending who is shooting you. Obviously, like if you have a tracer shooting you, or you have a soldier shooting you, or someone shooting you from afar, you can potentially heal through the damage until you get to a better position, until a teammate helps you, or you know, the enemy is dealt with. Also, another change made to self-repair was that basically a resource meter was added to it, very similar to D.Va's shield ability. So instead of it being just an infinite usage ability, basically, it now has a meter. So the meter will deplete as you're using self-repair, and it'll recharge when not in use. Now, considering all the changes that Blizzard has made to Bastion, I think that in his current state, he's pretty balanced. I mean, the community and Jeff Kaplan agreed that previously to him coming out of PTR, he was a little too overpowered with that 35% passive damage reduction while in tank or sentry mode. but bringing it down to 20% and giving players enough time to test him out in various different games and team compositions, I think most people are happy with how Bastion is. And we will probably be seeing him used in competitive matches more often, and most definitely in casual matches. So, I mean, I think for experienced players, he still is probably not the safest and most viable choice. But for lower levels and beginners to the game, I think that he will still be a very powerful character and definitely viable for a lot of team compositions, at least on defense more than attack, because you know, nobody really likes an attack Bastion. Do you think that Bastion is overpowered with the recent changes, or is he finally balanced and viable again? Let me know what you guys think in the comments section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe as well for more videos in the future. With everything said and done, I will definitely see you in the next one. We'll be right back.